Enough with the lecturing. Let's try to figure out how to write some SQL that's going to actually generate some kind of relationship between two different tables. So in this video, we're going to generate a table of users to start. We're going to make sure that this table has an ID column, and we're going to figure out how to set up this column as a primary key column. When we set it up as a primary key column, that's going to make Postgres treat it in a very specific, very unique way. We're going to make sure this users table also has a username column as well. We'll make that a varchar 50 for right now. Okay, so let's get to it. I'm going to once again use pg-sql.com. Now, if you want to, you can reset your database. We've already created a table inside this database. You might remember the cities table. I don't really want to work with that cities table anymore. So I'm going to reset my database, which is going to wipe out all the tables inside of it. This is entirely optional. I'm just doing it to make sure I'm starting off with a totally clean slate. Then after doing that, I'm going to write out some SQL that's going to create this users table with an ID and a username column. So you might recall that to create a table, we'll write out create table and then the name of the table. We'll then put in a set of parentheses. And then inside of here, we'll list out all the different rows, or excuse me, all the different columns that we want this table to have. So we definitely want this thing to have an ID column. And then you'll notice in this diagram, I specified a type of integer. And it definitely looks like there are integers going inside there. But if we just specified a type of integer, then it would be up to you and I to somehow generate all these different IDs. And we would also have to write out some code, presumably, to make sure that we always generated some kind of unique ID. Rather than going through all that pain, we can rely on a little helper from Postgres itself. I'm going to put in a data type for the ID column of serial. The serial data type tells Postgres that we wanted to generate the values in this column for us automatically. The serial keyword in particular means that whenever we start to insert values into users, we are not going to provide an ID at all. Instead, we are only going to provide a username. When we do so, Postgres is then going to jump in and generate an ID for us. The serial keyword means that it's going to start off by generating a value of 1 to start. As we then insert a second user, it will then take whatever the last ID that was generated for us, add 1 to it, and then assign it to the second record. When we put in the next user, we'll then get the next available integer, and then the next user, we get the next available integer. So as we insert additional users, the ID will be incremented by 1 every single time for us. After serial, we're then going to mark this column as primary key. This adds on some special performance benefits to looking up records inside the user's table when we are trying to look up records using the ID. Then after the ID, we'll see that we also want these things to have a username, and it will be of type varchar 50. So remember, varchar 50 means that we cannot insert any strings longer than 50 characters here, and if we do, we're going to see an error. Okay, so that's pretty much it for our user's table. Let's go ahead and run this. Looks like it was successful. Now I'm going to go ahead and try to insert a user into this table. So I'll do an insert into users, and then we're going to specify the one column that we want to try to provide here. Remember, the ID column is now going to be automatically generated for us, so we do not have to specify an ID when we insert a new user. The only thing we have to specify now is the username. So I'm going to add in 4 different users. I'll give them similar usernames to what you see right here. So I'm going to say users. I'm only going to put in the username. And we're going to stick in some values. And remember, if we want to add in multiple records at the same time, we'll put in our set of parentheses and then a single quoted string inside of here. For the first one, I'll put in Monahan93. I'll put a comma on the other side. What is the next one called? Pfeffer, that old boy. Old Pfeffer trying to sign up for an account. There we go. About, I don't know, what was the other one? Psy93 Onus or something like that. And whatever the last one was, 99 Strowman. There we go. Make sure you've got the commas at the end of each of those parentheses. And the last one will have a semicolon instead. So let's now run this. So we've now added 4 users into our users table. So now let's try to query that users table, pull out all the records we just added. And all I want to do right now is verify and make sure that we actually got an ID inserted for each individual user. So I'm going to replace that with a select star from users. I'll run that. And sure enough, there we go. We've got an ID of 1234 for those four users that we just inserted. Each ID is 100% unique. And again, we do not intend to change these IDs manually at any point in time. ID number one is always for user Monahan 93. Two is always for Pfeffer, and so on. Okay, so that is how we generate a new table with an automatically provided ID. So let's take a brief pause. When we come back in the next video, we'll start to set up this photos table as well. We'll make sure that we also give it this user ID column, which is supposed to be a foreign key.